One favorite question that globe earthers ask flat earthers is, how come that people at different longitudes see the same stars in the south, although they, according to the Gleason map, the map of choice of many flat earthers, all look in completely different directions? The answers, if any, vary from, you don't live in a model, the Gleason map isn't my flat earth map. People at different longitudes do see the same stars, but at different times. And of course, proof that these people see the same stars. This leads to all kinds of heated discussions, not one of which I have seen result in any kind of agreement. So I thought, let's formulate the question a little different. Do all people at different longitudes looking at the same heavenly phenomenon at the same time look in the same direction? The 25th of October we had the pleasure of watching a partial solar eclipse. That is, I thought I could watch this. I had my gear out, but unfortunately the sky was overcast, so I had to rely on watching the partial solar eclipse on internet. I found a YouTube live stream from a channel named Time and Date, where they showed the phenomenon from different places simultaneously. Link is in the description. I decided to make screenshots when different locations were shown with the same timestamp. At the end, I had screenshots of Tromsø, Norway, Abu Dhabi, Istanbul and Naples. All of these observers were looking at the same phenomenon at the same time, 10:25 UTC and 11:02 UTC. So let's first establish in what direction the observers of the partial solar eclipse were looking at those times, that is, on the Gleason map. This is that Gleason map with the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. According to most flat earthers, the Sun follows a circular trajectory from Capricorn to Cancer and back. That would mean that around the 25th of October the Sun would be following this purple circle. At 11:02 UTC, that's 13:02 local time, Tromsø was looking 189 degrees south. Abu Dhabi, local time 15:02, would be looking 235 degrees southwest. At the same time, Istanbul, local time 14:02, would be looking 202 degrees south-southwest. On the Gleason map, those directions together would look like this. Notice that the directions are not exactly parallel, but they will cross at a distance far greater than the size of the flat earth on the Gleason map, and they most certainly don't cross at the position the Sun is supposed to be on the 25th of October, according to flat earthers like David Weiss. This is, again, an indication that the Sun should be much farther away than flat earthers claim it to be. Now at 10:52 UTC, Tromsø, local time 12:52, is looking at 186 degrees south. Abu Dhabi, local time 14:52, at 233 degrees southwest, and Naples, local time 12:52, at 182 degrees south. On the Gleason map, those directions together would look like this. And again, the directions are not parallel, but they will cross at a distance far greater than the size of the flat earth on the Gleason map. And again, they don't cross at all at the point where the Sun is supposed to be in the flat earth world. This is another indication that the Sun should be much farther away than flat earthers claim it to be. In fact, the Sun, according to real-world observations, would be at an impossible position that is outside the Tropic of Capricorn, the outermost position of the Sun in reality. This is a clear demonstration that the Gleason map cannot be a depiction of the flat Earth. And it is a clear demonstration that the Sun model that flat earthers use, like in the Sun Moon app from David Weiss, doesn't and cannot correspond to reality. Flat Earth has another major problem. It doesn't work. But hey, what's new?